Go ahead and turn your caps lock and cough. When it comes to the health of your computer, the principles of avoidance, drainage, and support should be considered. Today we'll discuss common sense ways to keep your computer healthy and operating at maximum capacity. If you're running ZYTO, working with computers comes with a job, but for many, applying a little common sense to the health and well-being of their machine may not be so obvious. If you want your computer to give you a good 4 to 5 years of healthy and productive life, consider and use these basic principles of health. First, avoidance. We need to be aware of the digital toxicity that's out there and how to avoid as much of this unhealthy sludge as we possibly can.
Ew.
Use some common sense, but remember, some of this can be a little bit sneaky, so try the following. Number one, never download pirated music or movies.
Yarr.
We find print on services that are given content of this nature away for free. There's usually a catch, and it can be deadly for your computer. Second, often when installing other software programs, there's sneaky ways of automatically including search bars. I hate those things. Or other browser add-ons that add to the digital sludge. Be sure to read and uncheck anything not directly associated with the software you're installing. Number three, avoid clicking, opening, or downloading anything that looks suspicious, including pop-up windows in general, especially ones that look outdated. Your pop-up blocker on your browser can usually help you avoid these. And finally, unknown email attachments. If you don't know who sent you an email, don't open it, let alone any unexpected attachments from friends. Now that brings us to drainage. Just like in life, some toxicity is unavoidable for computers over time. Files get copied, transferred, created, deleted, etc. And in the process, things need to be cleaned up. Remember the following when you need to drain the strain on your computer. Uninstall any software you no longer use. Number two, run a disk defrag about once a month. That's probably a pretty good place to start. And third, don't forget to empty the trash and free up hard drive space. So that finally brings us to support. Along with avoiding and draining those digital goobers that can slow down your computer system, here are three simple support protocols to do with your computer on a regular basis. Number one, run operating system and software updates at least monthly. You can check with your operating system provider to find out how to do that. Number two, get yourself a good antivirus software and run a virus scan. It's recommended that you do this weekly, but you can often set this up to run at night when you're sleeping so you don't have to sit there while it goes through every single file on the computer. Third, regularly run a hard drive backup. Keep only what you need on your hard drive, backing up the rest to a portable or cloud-based drive. This helps maintain your computer's digital weight. The less weight it's carrying, the less it has to process at any given time. Even if you've done a good job at maintaining the health of your computer, remember that computers age much faster than our bodies. It's highly likely that your computer may need to be retired if it's 4 or 5 years old. For older technology, it can also be difficult to get adequate support from your local IT guy. Keep that in mind if you're beginning to face more and more episodes of technological seizure, frozen screens, or a sluggish response even after you've applied the suggested protocols. However, your computer is experiencing these symptoms and is still fairly young, you'll want to consult with a professional. Consider looking for a local IT specialist. Often this expert can be found at the same place you bought your computer. Now, just like any good holistic practitioner would say, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. With technology, the same holds true. Until next time, happy scanning.